Morning students, we will continue the next problems of increasing decreasing functions. Okay.
Increasing and decreasing functions. So about this topic, 6.2 exercise, 12th question, 12th number, which of the following intervals, which of the following functions? Which of the following functions are strictly decreasing? Strictly decreasing on 0.5. In that first with the cos x. Second bit, cos 2x. Third bit, cos 3x. Fourth bit, tan x. So, out of four, which of the following functions are strictly decreasing on 0.5 between the interval 0.5? Correct. Let us take first of all A. F of x is equal to 10 cos x. F of x is equal to cos x. Differentiate with respect to x. Cos x is continuous and durable and means of which the function is defined. Differentiable with respect to x. Therefore, f dash x, cos x derivative, d by dx of cos x, d by dx of cos x value minus sin x. So x lies between 5/2, lies between 0.5. So this is nothing but the first quadrant. X value in first quadrant here is sin x. Sin x value, suppose you this is sin. Sin x in first quadrant is positive. F dash x minus sin x is negative. Minus sin x is negative. Therefore, f dash x is negative. F dash x is negative. Sin x value positive. Positive into this minus value, negative. So negative means what happened?
F dash x, then f dash x less than 0, therefore f is decreasing.
Strictly decreasing function.
F is strictly
decreasing on 0.5. Right. Second bit. F of x is equal to cos 2x. F of x is equal to cos 2x. Differentiate with respect to x. Differentiate with respect to x. Therefore, f dash x is equal to d by dx of cos 2x, d by dx of cos 2x, d by dx of cos 2x derivative minus sin 2x into d by dx of 2x derivative, 2x derivative 2, therefore minus 2 sin 2x. So finally f dash x value
this one f dash x value
minus
sin 2x minus 2 sin 3x right. So x belongs to 0 comma pi bar, x lies between 0 and pi bar. So sin 2x, sin x value positive first quadrant, sin 2x value also positive first quadrant, but minus into this sin value
negative value, therefore f dash x is negative, means f dash x less than 0.
So sin x in 0 comma pi by 2 interval means that is in first quadrant positive value to negative sign
is negative, therefore f is strictly decreasing.
So in first beta f of x is equal to cos x strictly decreasing, second beta cos 2x is also strictly decreasing. Okay,
take this time.
Okay students, third one. See, f of x is equal to cos 3x. F of x is equal to cos 3x. Differentiate. With respect to x. Differentiate with respect to x. F dash x is equal to same d by dx of cos 3x divided by minus sin 3x, and again d by dx of 3x. So this is equal to what is that? Minus 3x divided by 3 minus 3 sin 3x. Right. Okay. What is f dash x? F dash x is equal to minus 3 sin 3x. Minus 3 sin 3x. Right. Given interval, what's given interval? 0 comma pi by 2. So means 0 less than x less than pi by 2. Comma. This is 3x. 3x value. Take 3x multiply 3 on both sides. 0, 3x less than 3 pi by 2. 3 pi by 2 means what? Which quadrant? That is in 270, third quadrant. X value lies between pi by 2. So in the previous problem also, x lies between pi by 2, 0 less than 2x less than 2 into pi by 2. So 0 less than 2x less than pi. So this is in the first quadrant and the second quadrant, 0 to pi. In 0 to pi sine value positive and sin cos 2x derivative, it got minus 2 sin 2x. However, this value positive in lies between in this one, minus value in this one, which is equal to minus. That's why second function is decreasing, means negative value. Okay, now we'll do this. Here in this sin 3x is positive as well as negative. From this, what you understand? Sin 3x is positive as well as is negative. That implies, what is the effect? F dash x is positive as well as it is negative. So finally, f of x is increasing function.
increasing as well as this decreasing.
Which sector increasing? It is increasing as well as it is decreasing. That is the third function. Fourth bit.
Tan x. F of x is tan x. F of x is equal to tan x. What is differentiate with respect to x? This is dbit. Differentiate with respect to x. F dash x is equal to
secant square x. Secant square x.
This also 0 less than x less than pi by 2.
0 less than x less than pi by 2.
So what is this one? X value like it will be, and also this is secant square x. Secant square x is a positive value greater than 0. Therefore, f dash x greater than 0.
F dash x
greater than anywhere you can take this one. In this secant square x value is positive about that 0 comma pi by 2 interval. Therefore, f dash x value is greater than 0, positive value. Therefore, f is strictly increasing.
Strictly increasing, right?
Yes.
So in this, which of the following functions are strictly decreasing? Means in first function, second function, strictly decreasing. These two are not. This is positive as well as negative. That implies it is not also strictly decreasing. In this one, tan x, f of x is equal to tan x, that's derivative is secant square x, however that secant square x value greater than 0, therefore f dash x greater than 0, this is strictly increasing, it's not strictly decreasing, only these two functions are strictly decreasing functions.
Okay, next problem.
Let I be the I be any product. That I be any interval.
Disjoint from minus 1 comma 1 prove that the function f given by f of x is equal to x plus 1 by x is strictly increasing on I. Strictly increasing on I. Right, given function. So what is the given letter? Given interval disjoint from minus 1 comma 1. Prove that the function of given is strictly increasing. So apart from this interval, means a disjoint from this one, remaining all cases, so this is strictly increasing. That is, you show it. Not for this interval strictly increasing. Remaining case, this is strictly increasing. X plus 1 by x, differentiate
with respect to x, therefore f dash x is equal to this value x derivative 1, 1 by x derivative minus 1 by x square, minus 1 by x square. Take LCM, what is LCM? X square minus 1 by x square minus 1 by x square. Therefore, x square minus 1 greater than 0, that implies x square minus 1 by x square also greater than 0. Greater than 0, that implies f dash x greater than 0. F dash x greater than 0. For now x belongs to I, that implies x not belongs to minus 1 comma 1. X not belongs to minus 1 comma 1. Therefore, f is strictly increasing. Strictly increasing. What is this case? X square minus 1. X square minus 1 greater than 0 means x plus 1, x minus 1 greater than 0, minus infinity to 1, union 1 to infinity, otherwise this can be written as like this one, minus 1 comma 1. So that's why this f is strictly increasing, disjoint from what is the set of I? Set is the subset of this one. So this is the subset of in interval. I interval is r minus minus 1 comma 1. So that is f is strictly increasing, disjoint from minus 1 comma 1. Okay, come on, see the 15th problem. Next 16th question. Prove that the function f given by f of x is equal to log sin x is strictly increasing or 0 comma pi by 2 and strictly decreasing pi by 2 comma pi. Okay, this one. Okay, prove that the function f, what is the function f of x is equal to log sin x, log sin x is strictly increasing on 0 comma pi by 2, means between the interval 0 comma pi by 2 first quadrant and strictly decreasing pi by 2 to pi second quadrant. In this case, we will show that this function is decreasing. In this interval, the function is increasing. Okay. Take function f of x is equal to log sin x. Log sin x. Now differentiate. Differentiate to find f dash x. With respect to x, what is f dash x? Means derivative of the function f of x. D by dx of logarithm of sin x. Logarithm of sin x. So this is treated as x. Log x derivative. Log x. Log x value is 1 by x. 1 by x into this is the function. So therefore again for this function derivative d by dx of sin x, again that function d by dx of sin x, f dash x is equal to d by dx of log sin x, therefore its derivative log x divided to 1 by x, and this is some function. So d by dx of the sin x, therefore f dash x is equal to 1 by sin x, derivative of sin x value cos x, cos x. So finally f dash x is equal to f dash x is equal to cos x. So this is the f dash x. Okay, the function is either increasing or decreasing depend on derivative f dash x by the theorem. F dash x greater than 0, it is strictly decreasing. Less than 0, it is decreasing. Okay, now we will check at 0 comma pi by 2. X 0 less than x less than pi by 2. So first and all, 0 comma pi by 2, x belongs to. How about cot x value? Cot x value, all trigonometric functions in first quadrant are positive. So that's why this value is positive. Cot x is positive in 0, pi by 2 interval. Therefore, positive is greater than 0. Therefore, f dash x greater than 0, f is strictly increasing. Strictly increasing function. Okay. Now, in this interval, and f dash x is equal to cot x. X between the interval pi by 2 less than x less than pi in this interval. Cot x means second quadrant. Second quadrant cot x value negative. Cot x is negative in pi by 2 comma pi interval. Therefore, f dash x is less than 0. F dash x less than 0 means what about the function f is? The function, therefore the function, therefore here the function f is strictly increasing. Therefore the function f is strictly decreasing. So first given function take f of x is equal to logarithm of sin x. First to find the using differentiation f dash x means derivative of the function is equal to, we got answer cot x. Cot x in first quadrant 0 comma pi by 2 is positive value, therefore f dash x greater than 0, greater than 0 means f is strictly increasing. Next f dash x cot x second case pi by 2 comma pi by 5, and cot x value in the second quadrant is negative, that's why f dash x less than 0. Less than 0 means the function is strictly decreasing. This is the 16th right. Prove that the function f given by f of x is equal to log cos x, same model above the problem is strictly decreasing. Decreasing on 0.5/2 and strictly increasing on 5/2, 5. Okay, same order.
Okay, go ahead. Quickly do homework.
Differentiate with respect to x this one. F dash x is equal to d/dx of log cos x. d/dx of log cos x. What is the logarithmic function differentiation? Means that is 1 by x, first of all 1 by cos x and d/dx of cos x derivative. d/dx cos x derivative minus sin x, that implies 1 that is equal to cos x into minus sin x. This is equal to minus tan x. Minus tan x. F dash x value minus tan x. First keep minus, not take, not consider. First tan x consider in the given interval 0.5/2 positive. First quadrant tan x positive. But positive into this negative value. So finally got answer, this is negative value. Therefore, in this interval, strictly decreasing. Y means less than 0. And second case, 5/2, 5. So this is second quadrant. Tan x value is negative. Negative into this negative, positive. So f dash x is greater than 0, positive. Therefore, strictly increasing in this interval. So like this will do homework. Same as this. Next one, 18. Prove that the function f of x, x cube minus 3x square plus 3x minus 100 is increasing in R. 18. Prove that the function given by f of x is equal to x cube minus 3x square and plus 3x minus 100 is increasing in R. R means real numbers. In R. Right. Differentiate function f of x. F of x is equal to x cube minus 3x square plus 3x minus 100. Differentiate with respect to x. Differentiate with respect to x. What is f dash x? Derivative of the function f dash x is equal to x cube derivative 3x square, 3 into 3 constant, 2x, 3x derivative 3, okay, not in bracket, 100, that is derivative 0. Therefore, this is equal to 3x square minus 6x plus 3. 3 possible to take common, 3 of x square minus 2x plus 1. This is f dash x. Any factors? F dash x is equal to 3 times of factors for the value. What is the value? 1 minus 2, middle term factorization. 1 multiple minus 1 to minus 1 minus 2 minus 1 into minus 1 plus 1. Therefore, x square minus x minus x plus 1. 3 of x common
x minus 1, minus 1 common, x minus 1 whole square. That implies 3 times of x minus 1 is the common, again x minus 1. Therefore, x 3 times of x minus 1 whole square, x minus 1 whole square.
Clearly, this function is greater than 0. It means any value you can take in the domain of the real numbers. Substitute in this one, whole square. 3 always here positive, plus 3, and substitute any value in this, whole square is there. This is greater than 0. Greater than 0. Therefore, f dash x, greater than 0. In some cases, means at 1, suppose if you take 1, 1 minus 1 0, equal to greater than or equal to 0. So therefore, this is increasing function. Therefore, f is increasing in R. Okay, f dash x minus got greater than 0. Suppose if you substitute 1, that is equal to 0. Therefore, f is increasing function. This is the 18th question. Next, 19. The interval. The interval in which y is equal to x square e power minus x is increasing is option A. Minus infinite to infinite, option B. Minus 2 comma 0, option C. 2 comma infinite, option D. 0 comma 0, 2. Okay. Take y is equal to x square e power minus x. X square e power into e power minus x. Differentiate with respect to x. With respect to x. dy by dx is equal to uv, product rule, uv formula. D by dx of x square into e power minus x. V into e power minus x into d by dx of x square plus x square into d by dx of e power minus x. This is dy by dx. Okay. Dy by dx is equal to e power minus x, x square derivative 2x plus x square into e power minus x derivative, e power minus x, and this is minus x derivative is equal to minus 1. E power minus x is the common. 2x minus x square. X also take common. X into e power minus x. This is e power minus x. E power minus x. 2 minus 2 minus x. Okay. For increasing or decreasing,
getting x value.
Divide by dx value.
Equal to 0. That implies
e power x and e power minus x always positive. That value.
E power minus x value greater than always greater than 0. That implies x of 2 minus x is equal to 0. Therefore, x is equal to 0 and x is 2 minus x is equal to 0. X is equal to 2. X is equal to 2. Therefore, we divide the 9 into 2 equal parts, 2 3 equal parts, 2 minus infinity to 0, 0 to 2, 2 to positive infinity. Take like that. They ask increasing the interval, which interval the function is increasing. So write here interval sine of f dash x nature of the function, nature of the function. First you take minus infinity to 0, minus infinity to 0, take any one value. 0, left of the 0, consider minus 1. Okay. Put in divide by dx. What is this value? Minus 1. E power minus of minus 1. E minus 1. And that implies, suppose minus 1. E power 1. 2 minus of minus 1. Plus 1. So finally, what is this value? Negative. So you got the value of negative. So this is negative. Okay. X into that negative. Negative positive is equal to negative. That implies this value is less than 0. Less than 0 means f is decreasing. Right. 0 to 2. Between 0 to 2, 1, take 1, 1 e power minus 1, that is 1 by e, positive, 2 minus 1, positive, therefore, positive into positive is equal to positive value, therefore greater than 0, f is increasing, f is increasing. Next, 2 to infinite. 2 to infinite. 2 to infinite means after 2, above 2, you take suppose 3. 2 to positive infinity. Substitute, suppose take 3. 3 e power minus that value. Positive value 2 minus 3. 2 minus 3. 2 minus 3 means so 3 into this is positive value 2 minus 3 minus 1. So plus into minus. Plus into minus. Therefore, this is negative less than 0. Your f is decreasing. F is decreasing function. So they ask what is the question? The interval in which y is equal to x square and e power minus x is increasing in which interval. So minus infinity to 0, option not there, clear. And 0 to 2 is there, is increasing, last option. And 2 to infinite option there, that is decreasing function. Therefore, correct answer is 0, 2 is the interval where f is. So, increasing, decreasing functions concept completed students. This is the increasing, decreasing functions.
Next concept is using derivatives, how to find equation of tangent and normal to the given curve of the function. So third concept, tangent and normal.
Tangent and normal.
So this is the concept of equation, tangent and normal. So we'll complete a date of change of quantities the concept related to the 6.1 exercise, increasing decreasing second exercise, tangent and normal of this third exercise. Suppose come to geometric coordinate. Suppose this is the line. This line makes an angle theta with x-axis in anti-clockwise direction. So that is called tangent. Means that is nothing but a slope. Slope is let it be m. Therefore, slope m can be treated as tan theta in terms of tan theta. So, what is slope m? Slope m is equal to tan theta. Theta is the inclination. Inclination. A line makes an inclination with the x axis. Therefore, slope or gradient. Slope or gradient is m is equal to m is denoted by letter. That one for slope is equal to tan. If suppose a line passing through two points, let it be PQ. Suppose some one curve, otherwise we can call this way. X1 Y1, X2 Y2. A line passing through two curves. X1, what is the slope? Given two points. Slope m is equal to difference of y coefficients divided by difference of x coefficients. Means x or s. That is y2 minus y1. y2 minus y1. Difference of y coordinates divided by difference of x coordinates. Slope m is equal to y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. For example, a given line in general form ax plus by plus c is equal to 0. This is the linear equation. How to find derivative? We convert into by is equal to minus ax minus c. Y is equal to, right, y as a subject, minus a by b of x minus c by a. So this is the line. What is slope? So compare with this one. Y is equal to mx plus c. Slope m is equal to minus a by b. Directly formula. What is slope? Without this convert to y is equal to direct right. What is the slope of this equation? Minus a by b. What is minus a by b? So minus of x coefficient. Minus of x coefficient divided by y coefficient. This is the form of a derivative. Given linear equation, how to find slope? Minus x coefficient divided by y coefficient, that's a minus a. Given two points, line passing two points, this is y2 minus y1, and for line makes an inclination, the slope is equal to apply tan theta. So theta will be any angle. Okay, suppose two lines are parallel, makes an angle alpha 1, same angle alpha 1. Two lines are parallel, what about their slopes? m1 is equal to m2, right? Two lines are perpendicular. Okay, we'll see this one. This is angle between two lines. Let it be, this is alpha, this is beta.
extrinsic beta is equal to theta plus alpha and theta is equal to beta minus alpha plus tan theta. Tan theta is equal to tan beta minus tan alpha divided by 1 plus tan beta into tan alpha. This is equal to m2 minus m1 by 1 plus m1 into m2 plus or minus. This is plus or minus. If you open matrix, is plus or minus. Tan angle between the two lines is equal to m2 minus m1 by m1 plus m1 into m2.
If suppose two lines are parallel means m1 is equal to m2. Two lines are perpendicular.
Two lines are perpendicular. Then what about slopes? M1 into M2 is equal to minus 1.
That is the condition. M1 into M2 is equal to minus 1. Here M1 is equal to M2. So in this section, how to find the tangent between the two curves? Suppose two curves intersect like this. So two curves intersect. What? How to find angle between them? So angle between the two curves is nothing but angle between the tangent. Angle between the tangent. Okay, so that is first you find tangent of the first curve, next you find tangent of the second curve, then you find angle between the two tangents, means two lines. Suppose angle between the two tangents, otherwise the two curves intersect orthogonally, what is the angle? Angle is nothing but theta is equal to 90 degrees. Okay. Orthogonally, two curves or two lines intersect orthogonally or perpendicularly. Here, in curve concepts, consider as orthogonally means angle between the two curves is equal to 90 degrees. It is nothing but the angle between the tangents. Right. Okay. So in geometry, how to find slope of spine? So in this, how to find the slope of the curve? So this is the curve f of x. This is P. P point x comma y. This is Q point delta x comma delta y. So this is makes an angle. So until here, this is x, this one change in x, delta x, so this is y. Is delta 1. So here also angle theta. How much? This align secant. PQ is the secant. Who means suppose if you take circle like this one. This is the secant. It passes through P comma Q. Q1. Q2, so Q3 and so on. Finally, Q tends to P. Q tends to P, not equal. Q tends to P. It acts as a tangent. So this is the secant. A line passing the two points of circle. Suppose this is circle, that is nothing but P. PQ is a secant. Gradually, it is tends to P. It is secant is nothing but it is a tangent. acts as a tangent.
Okay.
Right. This is f of x. Y is equal to f of x equal. And pq is secant. Its points are x, comma y. And change in x something that is delta x here to here. So that is, therefore, delta x, delta y means this value is equal to delta y, the point. Sorry, this is x plus delta x. X plus delta x. And this is y plus delta y. Y means here this is x, this one delta x. X plus delta x. This one is y plus delta y. Y plus delta y. Q value. Right. Give names PQ. This is M. M. R. Otherwise, okay. PQ. This is M. This is L. M, L, Q. R, P, Q. R, P, Q here. R, P, Q is nothing but these two are, this line and this line are parallel. This line and this line is parallel. So that's why this angle is equal to corresponding angles are equal. Therefore, R, P, Q is equal to that implies otherwise nothing but MLQ. ML, sorry. MLQ, RP, no problem. MLQ or MLQ, right? MLQ, RP is equal to what? Theta. Is equal to theta. Okay. RPQ. RPQ is equal to theta. That is nothing but the. So what is this one? QR. QR by PR. QR by PR. QR can be written as QM minus MR or RM. Next, PR can be written as this is nothing but the total until here. This value. Take OM, OM minus this value, OM. Otherwise, if we take this one, LM, let it be X. So this is nothing but an angle psi. Nothing but an angle psi. Therefore, this is N, OM, OM minus, OM minus NM, OM minus, not NM, we want PR, sorry, OM minus OM, that is equal to QM means Y plus delta Y. Y plus delta Y minus MR minus Y. Next, OM. OM is nothing but what is this value? X plus delta X. Next, ON subtract. ON means X. So YY cancel, XX cancel. So finally, the answer delta YY. Delta x, delta y by delta x. Okay, right. Angle RPQ, angle RPQ. So here Q tends to P. Suppose Q tends to P. Delta x tends to 0 as Q tends to P. So delta x tends to 0 as Q tends to P. Therefore, angle RPQ is nothing but let it be tan theta. Tan theta is equal to finally, that is delta y by delta x. Limit theta tends to, q tends to p means so that is nothing but theta is acts as a tangent. Q tends to p means so q coincides with this line, This is the tangent.
Coincide with this line.
So theta tends to psi. Theta tends to psi. Therefore, tan theta is equal to limit of delta x tends to 0, delta y by delta x. Delta y by delta x. Therefore, that implies what is this value? Tan psi. Tan psi is equal to delta y by delta x. So that is nothing but p tends to q. Delta x means p tends to q. Means p tends to q. Therefore, it acts as a delta y by delta x. This is equal to dy by dx. Dy by dx. So therefore, tan psi is equal to, tan psi is nothing but the slope of the line. Slope of the tangent. This line makes an angle psi. Therefore, tan psi is equal to dy by dx. Therefore, here, slope of the tangent. Slope of the tangent is dy by dx. Okay. Okay, students. Q tends to P. Q tends to P. This is nothing but what is your P2 secant? P2 secant becomes PT tangent. So this is PT tangent. PT tangent. Okay, right? Theta tends to psi. This is theta tends to psi. And theta tends to psi. Therefore, that implies P tends to Q. Limit P tends to Q. Tan theta is equal to. So, this is the smallest value. Delta x tends to 0 only. Take delta x tends to 0. This is P tends to Q. And that is equal to delta x tends to 0. Therefore, tan psi is equal to dy by dx. Slope of the tangent is dy by dx. And what is slope of the normal? Normal means perpendicular to the tangent. Slope of the normal. Slope of the normal is equal to minus perpendicular, both one to one, each to each. So two lines are perpendicular. Two lines are perpendicular means what about the slope? M1 into M2 is equal to minus 1. M1 and M2 is equal to minus 1. So normal slope we want, M2 means minus 1 by tangent square. So write like that. Slope of the normal is equal to minus 1 by slope of the tangent. Slope of the tangent. Therefore, minus 1 by dy by dx at the this also. Slope of the tangent at some point. X is equal to x naught. So, come otherwise some point P. Okay, this also some point P. That implies minus dx by dy. So, students, in the quoted geometry, slope of the line is given inclination. Direct inclination means that is tan theta. M is equal to tan theta. And given two points, slope of the line is equal to difference of y coordinates divided by difference of x coordinate. That implies y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. Right. Suppose given any straight line, linear equation, what is the slope? Minus of x quotient divided by y quotient, that is minus a by b. For this, in this concept, given curve, so any curve, some f of x is equal to for example, in first exercise, take 3x⁴ minus 4x. 3x⁴ minus 4x. find the slope of the tangent to the curve.
Find the slope of the tangent to the curve again. So
how to find the slope of the tangent for this curve, which is nothing but d by dx.
So find out that this is what f dash x. So finally find out the derivative
and a given point also
at x is equal to 4. At x is equal to 4, after finding the derivative, substitute at x is equal to x value 4 in the differentiation of the function. Like this, to find the equation of the tangent.
What is the equation of the line? Y minus y1 is equal to, right here, there is this line. Okay. What is the equation of a line passing through one point?
Y minus y1 is equal to m into x minus x1.
So here, in this, how to find it? So here also, y minus y1 is equal to, here slope is dy by dx. Dy by dx, slope m, x minus x1. So this is the tangent equation. What is normal equation? Normal equation also y minus y1 minus 1 by divided by dx into minus 1 by divided by dx x minus x1. So this is the normal equation. Normal equation, this is tangent equation. Tangent equation. This is ordinary given line. A line passing through one point having slope y minus y1 is equal to x minus x1 is straight lines. In this, y minus y1 is equal to in place of slope m, that is nothing but dy by dx. So, equation of the normal y minus y1 is equal to minus 1 by dy by dx into x minus x1. Okay, students, we will solve the problems in this concept. Next class.